Good morning. We are Beyond Gibbous Moon, September 27, 2020. Good morning. This is Precious Moments. Life Matters. Organic Lifestyle Today. Enjoy your lifestyle today. And your host, Laurel Sobol. Every day, listen to a section of the videos here and let Yashua take you where you need to be. I'll take a moment to pause as I pray for world peace. I pray all day, all night, year round, and I pray in advance and post-pray for the world. And grab yourself your organic tea or coffee or other organic foods and beverages. Make sure they are pure of all other ingredients and toxins. We'll scroll through these books here. Actually, I can't make it larger. I don't know why I can't make it larger. Oh, okay. Here we go. Made it a little larger. You can tell it. I love canaries. They're fantastic friends. And they always are positive and intelligent. It's amazing how Yashua creates beings of all size and dimension with wisdom loaded into them, including the trees and the plants and the medicinal herbs and the foods and spices. I might scroll through these books and the art covers you see, but each art piece is a work of art and inspired by something going on in my life at the time. These were inspired by my brother, my late brother. Spiritually, he will always be with me and part of my soul. He inspired these trees in a series. The holidays are coming up. Now is a great time to think of what you would like to buy for yourself, get yourself, make for yourself, give to others. I'm finding a passage in the Psalms here. That's what we're aiming for this week. This is Hawaii. There's a waterfall. I can't really see it, but it's there. Right there. It's right there. It's right there. It's in the sunrise. silly. Something's right in front of our nose. We can't see. Oh, yeah. Well, we'll come over here and start with this one here. Of course, one of my favorite composers is Laurel. Mm-hmm. Livestock, livestock, and WordPress weddings, choosing organic fabrics, and foods and beverages. Psalms are perfect gifts, and affordable at Amazon.com Productions. Wedding Day Joy Journals, perfect gifts. Proverbs, gifts, and gifts, perfect. And remember to plant 100 trees, and if you're joining with another in a marriage, plant 230 trees to celebrate the event. Your wedding should be beautiful. Nothing says beautiful like organic fibers, materials, textiles, silks, cottons, linens, brocades, and more. Your wedding should be beautiful. Nothing says beautiful like organic fibers, materials, textiles, silks, and cotton, linens, brocades, and more. Are you watching this ladybug on the bottom right fly? It's a miracle. It's just fantastic. I mean, I could just watch this every second. It's just so
I picked this selection of psalms, and there are many, many books to choose with partial and entire psalms, because the marriage that stays close to God and His directives and His love and commandments is going to be the marriage that will face likeliest success and happiness over the years. Psalms comfort the heart and soul. Give praise to God. Lift the plight of humanity. Give courage and strength. Soli Deo Gloria forever. Look to the Lord and His strength. Seek His face always. Psalm 105:3. Judgment, nor sinners in the assembly of the righteous. For the Lord watches over the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked leads to destruction.
Thank you.
I'm going to X out of this window now and take you over here. Oops. And I want to show you some things here, but this goes back to, let's see. I'll show you some selections, and this kind of comes up especially when school starts for some reason. I feel like kids need friends. Students, all ages, teenagers, young adults, they need friends. What is more wonderful than little dragon friends? So, here's an amazing book, Interactive Learning and Journal, which you'll see time and again. Organic Lifestyle Today, St. Patrick's Day. Dragon Joy. These make great backpack accompaniments, or if you're homeschooling, or just at home and you're having notes, or huge, or just wonderful things to write in. Your journals are great. Sea Dragon. Dragon Cocoa Puff. Dragon Paws, Red Racer. I hope you're enjoying the art show as you scroll. Each one of these is, took time and care. It wasn't done automatically. I took the time and care to go and produce each one of these. In the striking colors you see, and that is the original. As you see, the price is almost nothing. It's something that it's very affordable. And I could jack it up. My more modern, later, as you can see, this is 2014. So this is 6 years ago. And the price is, as you can see, $17. It went up. And now they are about $9.99. But I could move the prices if I want. Look at this amazing dragon. Let's see. Yeah. Okay. And a dragonfly. Red magical dragonfly. So while we're here, because I'm going to be talking about dragons today. Giants. The most wonderful, ancientest, most ancient of all the animals here. And each of these has a story to tell. I'm trying to scroll down to my Nez Perce Mimicry Legends. Here it is. The Nez Perce Mimicry Legend of the Giants. Okay, this is a must-have. You must check that book out. Excuse me. And I say that, and there might be two versions. I say that because... Here we go. The legends and stories. Okay, should be in there too. These are stories that all interconnect. So you've really got to get them all and just relish reading them. They were made with integrity, ethics, and love. And how this all started was when I was 24 years old, I was introduced to a man who would become my ancestor. He's my late great grandfather right now, James Martin, Martin, a great grandson of Rolling Thunder Through the Mountains, Chief Joseph, and I was adopted by him and his wife Lottie in Rogue River, Oregon in 1987. And I thought that was an amazing, amazing day when that happened. And a sharing of the Nez Perce legends was in order and would come through time. So check that book out, and of course there's other amazing books. Oops. Okay, so we are here. Let's take a look at this. Before I begin, I want to say something. I want to say that the giants were here a long time, and you may have been watching. I mean, the watchers who were kicked out of heaven. They were like Satan. They made bad choices, right? And they got kicked out of heaven. They might have been responsible for, in fact, I would say they are responsible for the extinction of the dinosaurs because they were around. Yashua does not destroy the creation. And I have been beseeching world leaders and countries to step out and step forth, and they do. They'll say, like, well, we're opposed to toxic ways of life. We're opposed to this and that. And then they get boom, bang, and rock, and layer of disaster after disaster in a man-made apocalyptic layer. Tri-geo-weather disease dispersal warfare that never ends. But they're not the only people afflicted. It's around the world, even in America. And the only people I have heard really say something was Israel. They said they were not complicit in the man-made apocalyptic star geo-weather disease dispersal warfare, which I think is fantastic. But I say kudos to Israel for them to say that, because during the paradise colossal warfare with precision missiles and non-UFO technology crafts, NASA and ISS, who are working with the genocide and the United Nations and the order and the elite cities, resilient cities. Resilient cities on Harvard, fake entities of caring and trusted sources. These people are very glad, and they're working with most, I think most of them are working with them. Basically, resilient cities moves in, agenda, it's an agenda 2130 factor down the road, and they promise goods and services that are fake goods and services. They seem like it's a good thing, but it's a genocidal tool, and only evil people work for them and sell their soul to do it. Where cities are basically essentially leveled, and then they're told that they will be come back off, like when they're leveled again, and the taxpayers are the ones who have to fit the bill and pay for the funerals. Although usually there's no funeral because it's incinerated automatically, you know, cost incineration, and then everybody gets to breathe all the structures and bodies of all the dead, dying, or deceased. Okay, and so. But Israel is the one who said they weren't responsible. So cool. Okay. Yay. Okay, let's give Israel a hand. Because we need every country to stand up like Israel and say no way. And you know, especially over like Mexico when there's world earthquakes and volcanoes going off. People have been noticing the Star Wars artillery cities that are floating above the crime scenes and amplifying and intensifying the disasters around the area. And this is going on. Including President Trump, who I've supported as far as a good person, but said the people were responsible for California Paradise fires, and I corrected him, but I haven't heard him rectify that. And also, he's into 5G and 6G genocide, which he knows about that too. And the psyops through your phones and your apps and your appliances and around the world, with zillions of cameras and NASA and many other entities and ISS, you can see right here, right through to the other side of the world. You can causing global warming and global changes. You know, when people are burned out, flooded out, they can't breathe, they lose everything, you know, what does it do? You've got to not push our Father out of it. These are this type of thing is what took out the dinosaurs. This is the type of thing that we're going through right now that took out all the people in Noah's, the prophet Noah's time. And the watchers took women, to be their, and they bred the giants such as the one in David and Goliath, and they were all over the world, the giants. They're still all over the world. They're still watching with humans, and any who are complicit and complacent are of the worst kind. Be careful, always walk with Yashua in a pure and good fashion. So this is an amazing book. I mean, yes, this is a book, and holidays coming up. We scroll through these dragons. I think we got some triceratops down here. I don't see the terrace. Okay, but we do have dinosaur books. Okay. I will add the okay, let's look at dinosaur. Let's look up dinosaur. Okay? And I'll show you what I mean. Okay. Let's look at this. Okay, this is like really cool dinosaurs. And you'll see how these tie into the giants, okay? Because these dinosaurs, Tyrannosaurus, isn't that cool? Enjoy my bird video here. Thank you for accompanying us today, little bird. I took a moment. Oh, these are one of my favorite birds. And we need to sing praises. It's Sunday. I celebrate the Sabbath. I celebrate Friday. I celebrate every day of Friday and Maker's Creation Day. I hope you join me with that. Stay well and healthy. This is the beginning of a new week. We are approaching a full moon, and more unprecedented, layered, man-made, apocalyptic stars that are therefore dispersing as they roll up to the solar cities. And pretending that the moon is that they've robbed the coppers down to your 50th to 100th grandchild.
can't let them do that anymore. I mean, you can't go to the bank and draft money that would cover 1,000 years of your future. Stock market so they can raid it again. They are unscrupulous. And they, if they really cared about their family, they would want to protect the earth. And they say that. We're protecting the earth, but they have wildlife services which kills billions of animals and insects and trees a year around the world. Billions and billions and billions. And the Forest Service, which also kills billions and billions and is responsible with BLM, Bureau of Land Management, and the National Forest Services, and they're all in cahoots with the destruction of the forest. So Rockefeller, these people also own a great amount of these forests, okay? And they're horrible managers and preservers. They're not doing any of that anyway. They're destroying where they are, where they live, and all the way out the core of the world, opposite ends of the world, throughout the world, inner space, outer space, and beyond, beyond our solar system, beyond our galaxy. They're sending moon further away. They're routing all of our gravitational magnetism in that of the moon and even solar plasma. We are solar plasma. We are plasma. But when it all comes down to the nothing, we're all light and we're love of our Creator. I think I will pick a special song today. A song I've recently put together. And I hope you will enjoy listening to it. And just a moment. I want to thank Israel again. Israel, of course, you are God's chosen people. You have not always walked right, but. Some of the people are over there, so that's good. Keep that up, and we need to have this around the world. This is called Frozen, it's a cover. And as you come back to singing it, and I hope you listen to it and add it to your prayer.
Storm rage on. flurries through the air and to the ground. My soul is spiraling, frozen froppers of snow all around. And one thought crystallizes into the next like an icy blast. I'm never going back. The past is in the past. But I'll learn from it at last. Let it go, let it snow, and I'll rise like a break of dawn. Let it go, let it snow, that perfect girl is gone. Here I stand in the light of day, let the storm rage on, and on, and on, and on. The cold never bothered me anyway. Did.
Of course, thank you for listening to this broadcast today. I've been your host. I'm Laurel Sobol of Laurel Sobol Productions, Organic Lifestyle Today. Enjoy your lifestyle today. Precious Moments Lifestyle Today. Basically, enjoy your moment. All that you are, all of our heritage that ever will be, that has been from the inception of time, that we were a speck in our Father's mind, our Creator's mind. Well, we're here, and this is what we have, the collective of what we are. That's why our birthdays are so emotional. No matter how we promise ourselves we won't be emotional on our birthday, it happens. And it happens for a good reason. So enjoy your birthdays every day. Today is your present, the present of all that you are. Give hope to yourself, your family, your world, and let your light shine for Yashua. Blessings, B'nai Kodesh. I hope you have a wonderful week. I would hope to join you tomorrow morning as I select a brand new broadcast to bring joy and awareness and energy to your life and connect you to your maker in a way that is so tight and so collected and so beautiful that nobody can ever, ever pull you apart from him. Remember, every last one of us is a precious creation of our maker. And if we drift away, he cares and he wants us to come back. So, B'nai Kodesh. B'nai Kodesh and B'nai Kodesh.